the massive installation of the Most Reverend William E. Laurie as the 16th Archbishop of Baltimore.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
I now invite Cardinal O'Brien.
Invito al Cardinale O'Brien ora.
Archbishop of Baltimore.
Obispo di Baltimore e ora amministratore apostolico dell'Archidiocese di Baltimore,
to greet the assembly
a dare la benvenuta all'Assemblea in questo gran dia.
Please be seated.
Siéntese, por favor.
Your Eminences,
Sus Eminencias,
Your Excellency, Archbishop
Biganow,
Your Excellency, Archbishop
Su Excelencia, Arzobispo Rory,
Archbishops and Bishops Arzobispos and Priests and Deacons,
y sacerdotes
men
y diáconos,
seminarians,
hombres y mujeres religiosos.
I welcome you to this Cathedral of Mary our Queen
Catedral de María,
as we participate in the installation of the 16th Archbishop of Baltimore. I welcome this opportunity to thank publicly His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI for the appointment of Archbishop Lory as my successor.
Por el, la designación del arzobispo Lory como mi sucesor, lo he conocido por muchos años. Es un hombre de gran experiencia, es inteligente y muy diligente para cuidar del pueblo de Dios. El arzobispo Lory encontrará en él en las próximas semanas que mi entusiasmo y mi bienvenida de usted
an echo many times over throughout this archdiocese. The devotion of our faithful to the Lord and His Catholic Church will be a great encouragement to you, as it has consistently been to Cardinal Keeler and me, and I'm sure to each of our predecessors. A special greeting of welcome to your parents, your aunts and relatives and friends from Bridgeport and Washington, Indiana and Kentucky, and how honored we are to have among us so many Knights of Columbus. I don't know if you've noticed. Led by our Supreme Knight, Carl Anderson. A new and grace-filled chapter begins today for America's most historic archdiocese, and for that we offer thanks, Eucharistic thanks to God.
Your Eminence Cardinal O'Brien, Your Eminences Cardinal Keeler, Stafford, Egan, McCarrick, O'Malley, Whirl, and Dolan. My brothers Archbishop and Bishops, dear priests, deacons, consecrated religious and lay faithful of the Archdiocese of Baltimore, dear friends in the risen Christ, on this wonderful occasion, it is my special privilege to convey to each one of you the warm greetings, paternal affection, and spiritual closeness of His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI. Today, we joyfully gather together in this beautiful cathedral dedicated to Mary, our Mother, for the solemn installation of His Excellency William Edward Lory as the 16th Archbishop of Baltimore. Historically, the Mother See of the Catholic Church in the United States of America, and where in the 1885, during the Third Council, the Venerable Baltimore Catechism was issued. In this most recent address to a group of American bishops on their ad limina visit, our Holy Father reflected on the importance of religious education and the faith formation of the next generation of Catholics in the vast country. I quote, "It is no exaggeration to say that providing young people with a sound education in the faith represents the most urgent internal challenge facing the Catholic community in your country. The deposit of faith is a priceless treasure which each generation must pass on to the next. By winning heart to Jesus Christ and shaping minds in the knowledge of Him, understanding and love of His Church. It is gratifying to realize that, in our day too, the Christian vision presented in its breadth and integrity proves immensely appealing to the imagination, idealism, and aspiration of the young, who have a right to encounter the faith in all of its beauty, its intellectual richness, and in its radical demands. Your Excellency, Archbishop Designate Lori, at this important moment of your priestly episcopal life and in the history of this local church, we congratulate you on your appointment and assure you of our spiritual support. We express our confidence that through your faithful ministry of teaching, governing, and sanctifying, you will win hearts to Jesus Christ and shape mind in the knowledge, understanding, and love of His Church, proposing the Christian vision of life in all its breadth and integrity, to the lasting spiritual betterment not only of your flock, but of American society at large. Your Eminence Cardinal O'Brien, I would indeed be remiss if I did not publicly thank you for your distinguished and valuable leadership as the 15th Archbishop of Baltimore, and more recently as its Apostolic Administrator. And now, with great joy, I will read an English translation of the Apostolic Letter by which the Holy Father appointed His Excellency William Lori, Archbishop of Baltimore. Benedict Bishop, servant of the servants of God. To our venerable brother William Edward Lori, until now Bishop of Bridgeport, at this time appointed ordinary of the Metropolitan Church in Baltimore, greetings and apostolic blessing. Among the sees located in the United States of America, the Archdiocese of Baltimore occupies a prominent place, for it is the oldest in the history of that distinguished nation. For this reason, in the faithful exercise of our office as the Vicar of Christ and Shepherd of the Universal Church, we take particular care to assign a suitable man of great pastoral experience capable of succeeding our venerable brother Edwin Frederick O'Brien, Cardinal of the Holy Roman Church, not long ago appointed Grand Master of the Equestrian Order of the Holy Sepulchre of Jerusalem in the governance of that church. Accordingly, venerable brother, we turn our attention to you, whom we judge as fit to fulfill this task, given the duties you have already, with a willing spirit, performed for the Church in Bridgeport, and the episcopal responsibility you have diligently carried out there. Therefore, after consultation with the Congregation for Bishops, by virtues of the fullness of our apostolic authority, by this letter, we release you from the bond of the Church in Bridgeport, and we choose and appoint you Metropolitan Archbishop of Baltimore. You will then be sure to inform in a fitting manner the clergy and the people of your Archdiocese about this your appointment. And we, in turn, exhort them not only to encourage you by their genuine filial devotion, but also to comply with you as their teacher in the zealous exercise of your ministry. For now, venerable brother, it is our earnest desire that, mindful of the importance of the office being entrusted to you, you will always lift up your eyes to the Blessed Virgin Mary, conceived without sin, through whose intercession you will surely be able to devote yourself completely to the spiritual edification and welfare of your flock. Given at St. Peter's on the 20th day of the month of March, in the year of the Lord 2012, the seventh of our pontificate, Pope Benedict XVI.
Let the College of Consultors examine the apostolic mandate. Let the apostolic mandate be shown to the assembly.
Thank you so much. Bless you.
Bless you.
Thank you so much. good to be with you. God bless you. Thank you. Working with you, Archbishop. Thank you for everything.
I look forward to working with you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Jay. God bless you.
In the name of the priests, welcome to the
worship. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jay.
On behalf of the deacon community here in the Archdiocese, we're joyful.
Thank you. Same here. Thank you. Hi, Diane. Thank you so much, Diane. Some folks to present to, okay?
Congratulations.
Hey, thank you so much.
You know, we always like to think about ourselves as the army of the church.
Yes.
The Baltimore Archdiocese, that makes us your army.
Thank you.
Put us to work when you need us.
We sure will. I sure will. Thank you. Thank you. And lovely to see you. Beverly, I look forward to seeing you. Thank you. Hi, sister. No introduction needed.
That we have been
look forward to visiting Gun Road one of these days. Great, sister. Thank you. Yes, indeed. I'm going to mention it today.
Thank you.
Okay, God bless you. Thank you.
This is Brother Lorenza.
Good to see you again. Yeah, good to be with you again, brother. It's going to be great. Thank you. Wonderful. Thank you. Hey, Barbara. God bless you. Thank you. It's good to see you. Look forward to you. Soon. I look forward to that. Thank you so much, Brian. Hey, Tom, this is you. So Tom, good to see you. Tom, thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you for your lovely love, too. Thank you. Thank you so much. Tom, once again, thanks for everything, Tom. A lot of work. We'll do together. Thank you so much.
On behalf of the youth ministers, we've been praying for you. We'll continue to do so.
So important. Thank you.
This is Andrew Fausto, who's representing our young adult ministry.
Yes, on behalf of the young adult ministry of Baltimore. We look forward to working with you to help establish Baltimore as really the city for young adults across America.
Excellent. That'd be a great goal. Thank you.
Catherine Broadwater, one of our campus ministers out in Western Maryland at Prosperity University.
Good to see you, Catherine. Thank you. Look forward to our work together. Thank you.
This is Myra and Angelo from
the Nice to meet you both.
They're
Thank
very
you.
Involved in the Marriage and Family Life Ministry.
Excellent.
In the
Archdiocese. Wow, what a
coordinator.
What great work. Thank you. Thank you both. Thank you. Thank you.
This is Melissa Pais.
I'm Melissa.
Involved with our youth ministry, Hispanic Kids Ministry.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Gracias. Thank you.
This is Judy Grill. She's in charge of the Baltimore area catechetical ministers.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Hey, Bill. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Pat Bennett is at our Daily Bread Employment Center.
Oh, Pat, nice to see you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow, Pat. Thank you. Thank you.
Evelyn Rosario at the Esperanza Center.
Hey, gosh, what a great thing. Gracias, gracias. Thank you.
This is Ann Shelton of the Excellency. Ann has been a 30-year volunteer at Catholic Charities.
That's wonderful. Gosh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey,
congratulations.
Thank
Welcome
you so
Baltimore.
Much. Thank you.
The Catholic Healthcare Group.
Okay,
here.
Great.
Bonnie Fitz, St. Agnes Hospital.
Nice to see you, Bonnie. Thank you.
We have the oldest hospital in Baltimore. I have
originally
from Baltimore, so I'm glad to welcome you here.
Good to be
here. Susan Davis is a very good friend.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Dr. Samuel Ross from Sponsor Corps.
Dr. Ross, nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Welcome.
Great to be with you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Doctor.
Mr. Jeff Matan from Good Samaritan Hospital.
Hey, Jeff, nice to meet you, too. Thank you. Thank you so much, Jeff. Thank you.
Susan DeCrane, St. Joseph's.
Hey, good to see you, too, Susan.
I bring greetings from our entire hospital. They know I'm here.
Great.
And I promise you our prayers.
Thank you so much. Look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you.
Sister Lorraine McGuire from Little Sisters.
Let's make it official. Good, thank you.
The Muslim community.
Honored to meet you, too. Same here, Imam. Thank you.
My colleagues in Bridgeport, Nasif.
Yes.
Imam Nasif.
Thank you.
A great man.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Thank you so much, thank you.
This is Bishop Douglas Miles of the Baptist community.
Bishop, very nice to see you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. We're going to work together. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Archbishop Dr. Arthur Abrams of the Great Faith Forest.
Congratulations.
Hey, nice to see you.
On behalf of the Jewish community, congratulations.
Thank you. I look forward to our work together and coming to know the community well. Thank you.
Absolutely, and I look forward to hosting them.
Thank you. Hey, great. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Mary Ellen.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'm delighted to introduce you, the mayor of Baltimore City, Stephanie Rollins.
Honored to meet you. Thank you so much.
City of Baltimore and all of our citizens, I welcome you.
Thank you.
I look forward to working with you.
Same here. Thank you for your lovely letter. I really appreciated that lovely letter.
So sit down.
And we'll get together real soon. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for representing everybody. Thank you. And thank you, Mary Ellen. Thank you. Do I have to turn the mic on? Okay. All right.
Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary as mother to be our mother also, grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exalting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the peoples. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul's escorts had taken him to Athens, they came away with instructions for Silas and Timothy to join him as soon as possible. Then Paul stood up at the Areopagus and said, "You Athenians, I see that in every respect you are very religious. For as I walked around looking carefully at your shrines, I even discovered an altar inscribed to an unknown god. What therefore you unknowingly worship, I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and all that is in it, the Lord of heaven and earth, does not dwell in sanctuaries made by human hands, nor is he served by any human hands because he needs anything. Rather, it is he who gives to everyone life and breath and everything. He made from one the whole human race to dwell on the entire surface of the earth, and he fixed the ordered seasons and the boundaries of their regions so that people might seek God, even perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from any one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since therefore we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the divinity is like an image fashioned from gold, silver, or stone by human art and imagination. God has overlooked the times of ignorance, but now he demands that all people everywhere repent, because he has established a day on which he will judge the world with justice through a man he has appointed, and he has provided confirmation for all by raising him from the dead." When they heard about resurrection of the dead, some began to scoff, but others said, "We should like to hear you on this some other time." So Paul left them, but some did join him and became believers. Among them were Dionysius, a member of the court of the Areopagus, and a woman named Damaris, and others with them. After this, he left Athens and went to Corinth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Efesios. Hermanos, cada uno de nosotros ha recibido la gracia en la medida en que Cristo se la ha dado. Él fue quien concedió a unos ser apóstoles, a otros ser profetas, a otros ser evangelizadores, a otros ser pastores y maestros. Y esto para capacitar a los fieles, a fin de que, desempeñando debidamente su tarea, construyan el cuerpo de Cristo hasta que todos lleguemos a estar unidos en la fe y en el conocimiento del Hijo de Dios, y lleguemos a ser hombres perfectos, que alcancemos en todas sus dimensiones la plenitud de Cristo. Así, ya no seremos como niños, zarandeados por las olas y llevados de un lado para el otro por el viento de cualquier doctrina, a merced de hombres malvados y astutos que conducen engañosamente al error. Por el contrario, viviendo sinceramente en el amor, creceremos en todos sentidos, unidos a aquel que es la cabeza, Cristo. De él, todo el cuerpo recibe su organización, su cohesión y su vida, según la actividad propia de cada una de las partes. Y así, el cuerpo va creciendo y construyéndose por medio del amor. Esta es palabra de Dios.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of Truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I told you that he will take from me what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
My special thanks to the cardinals who are with us today, and in a special way, my thanks to the Papal Nuncio, Archbishop Carlo Maria Vigano. Thank you for representing our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, and please convey to him the sentiments of loving communion of all here present. My greetings and my thanks to the archbishops and bishops who join us today, as well as the priests, deacons, and religious and laity of the Archdiocese of Baltimore, as well as honored guests from the Archdiocese of Washington, the Diocese of Bridgeport. I greet and welcome my dear parents, as well as family members and friends from Southern Indiana, and many other places, together with interfaith and ecumenical representatives and those who represent state and local government, welcome to one and all. Doesn't this seem like a good day to reflect on what a bishop does? Guess it does. One answer to that question was given by a third grader at the Convent of the Sacred Heart School in Greenwich, Connecticut, on the occasion of one of my visits. Asked what a bishop does, she enthusiastically put up her hand and said, "He moves diagonally and protects the king." A so now you know. Who a bishop is and what he's supposed to be was brought home to me in this magnificent cathedral of Mary, our Queen, about 17 years ago. It was here, in this very sanctuary, that Cardinal Keeler and Cardinal Hickey presented me to Pope John Paul II for the first time as a newly ordained bishop. Here I stood before Pope John Paul II, an ideal priest and a saintly bishop, whose life spoke more eloquently even than his words about my vocation. And after I had been presented, I sat down and listened as John Paul II proceeded to describe the unique heritage of this great Archdiocese of Baltimore. This afternoon, I want to express the common debt of gratitude that we owe to William Cardinal Keeler, who so loved and fostered the living heritage that is ours. Cardinal Keeler, thank you so very, very much. I also want to join with you in thanking Edwin Cardinal O'Brien, who in challenging times gave to this Archdiocese of Baltimore the care of a good, wise, and loving shepherd. Thank you so, so much, Cardinal O'Brien. Friends, we have just heard how St. Paul preached the gospel in the Areopagus of Athens, the ultimate public square in the height of the Roman Empire. Paul did not hesitate to bring the gospel of Christ into that place where ideas that mattered were discussed and debated. By pointing to the altar of an unknown God, Paul sought to make connections between the culture of the Athenians and the gospel. But never did it occur to St. Paul to present the gospel as mere ideas, as an alternative philosophy. Rather, in the public square, St. Paul preached Christ crucified and risen as the source of life itself, of meaning and of salvation. Yes, his words were met with skepticism, even ridicule. Yet, among some who heard him, some came to believe. Few people in history went to more Areopagi than did Pope John Paul II as he traveled the breadth and length of the globe preaching the gospel, as indeed his successor, Pope Benedict XVI, continues to do. In doing this, they're teaching us all how important it is not only to bring the gospel into the public square, but indeed to defend the right to do so for ourselves and for all believers. Standing in this cathedral, Blessed Pope John Paul II said, and I quote, "The challenge facing you, dear friends, is to increase people's awareness of the importance for society of religious freedom, to defend that freedom against those who would take religion out of the public domain and establish secularism as America's official faith." He went on to say it's vitally necessary for the very survival of the American experience to transmit to the next generation the precious legacy of religious freedom and the convictions which sustain it. When the bishops from this mid-Atlantic region recently visited Pope Benedict XVI, he spoke forcefully about the need to uphold religious liberty in our country. And he said this: with her long tradition of respect for the right relationship between faith and reason, the Church has a critical role to play in countering cultural currents which seek to promote notions of freedom detached from moral truth. He went on to say that the legitimate separation of church and state cannot be taken to mean that the church must be silent on certain issues, nor that the state may choose not to engage or be engaged by the voices of committed believers in determining the values that will shape the future of the nation. Dear friends, we do not seek to defend religious liberty for partisan purposes, as some have suggested. No, we do this because we are lovers of a human dignity that was fashioned and imparted not by the government, but by the Creator. We defend religious liberty because we are lovers of every human person, seeing in the face of every man and woman the face of Christ, who loved us to the end and who now calls on us to love and serve our neighbor with that same love he bestowed on us. We uphold religious liberty because we want to serve those in need while contributing to the common good in accord with the Church's social teaching, and to do so with compassion and effectiveness through Catholic Charities, the largest private provider of human services in the state of Maryland. We do this because Archbishop John Carroll's generation of believers and patriots gave us a precious legacy that has enabled the Church to worship in freedom, to bear witness to Christ publicly, and to do massive, amazing works of pastoral love, education, and charity, and to do them in ways that are true to the faith that inspired them in the first place. And yes, we defend religious liberty in fidelity to the wisdom of James Cardinal Gibbons, who withstood in the breach those who said it wasn't possible to be a practicing Catholic and a loyal American. "I belong to a country," he said, "where the civil government holds over us the aegis of its protection without interfering with us in the legitimate exercise of our sublime mission as ministers of the gospel of Christ. Our country," he said, "has liberty without license and authority without despotism." Now, dear friends, you and I must be loyal Americans by being bold and courageous Catholics. So friends, let's be of good cheer. Let's never imagine that the faith we profess with such personal conviction is just a private matter. By its nature, faith is public, for faith is meant to be spread far and wide and acted upon through church institutions and in the witness of individual believers. Let's never shrink from entering the public square to proclaim the person of Christ, to teach the values that flow from faith and reason, to defend the sanctity of life from conception till natural death, and to uphold the institution of marriage as between a man and a woman, and to serve effectively those in great need with convictions born of the moral law. But you know, St. Paul did not carelessly enter the public square. Not only did he first study carefully the culture and religious practices of the Athenians, no, he came filled with God's love, poured into his heart by the Spirit. He knew that the churches where he had preached the faith had to be strong and vibrant. He knew that for his witness of faith to be believed, that its members must not only stand fast in the truth of the gospel, but indeed also to live the truth in love, to live in accord with the truth we have received. Can there be any doubt how challenging this is? The church is endowed with the holiness of Christ, but always in need of purification. For those of us who are her members, we stand in need of God's mercy, and the mission of evangelization entrusted to us all, this requires the witness of a blameless conscience. Today, how hard we should pray that I will be a wise and holy bishop who seeks to model my life on the Good Shepherd. Pray that as the year of faith announced by Pope Benedict XVI unfolds, I will not only teach the faith but bear witness to it, and to do so in a manner that helps to heal the breach between faith and culture. Pray that in God's grace I might foster that unity which makes the gospel credible, so that together we can warmly invite those who have left the church for whatever reason to return home in joy and peace. Today, let's pray also earnestly for our auxiliary bishops, for Bishop Madden, for Bishop Rosansky, and for our wonderful retired bishop, auxiliary bishop, Bishop Newman. Let's pray for our priests and our deacons who serve our parish communities every day without counting the cost. Dear brother priests, how happy I am that so many of you shared with me your hopes and dreams and concerns for this local church you love so dearly. I sense your ardent desire for an ever deeper sense of solidarity and unity, as also your desire that the church remain a strong and compassionate presence in the city of Baltimore and in all parts of the Archdiocese, including Western Maryland. You seek to marshal and shape all its God-given resources for the sake of the gospel and for the sake of those we serve or should be serving, including the blessing of a wonderful African-American community and the blessing of a growing presence of Spanish-speaking Catholics in our midst. And because all of us so cherish the priesthood, because all of us are part of an archdiocese with the oldest seminary in the United States and the second oldest, because we love the priesthood to which you've dedicated your lives, let us never be content to think that God isn't still raising up priestly vocations. To those of you who think that Christ may be inviting you to follow him in the priesthood or the consecrated life, I make this personal appeal. I ask you to open your hearts generously to him. Do not delay your response. The Lord will help you to know his will. He will help you to follow your vocation courageously. On this installation day, I wish to thank and acknowledge women and men in consecrated life who serve so generously and effectively in the Archdiocese. With you, I think of the canonized and beatified religious who served here, St. Elizabeth Ann Seton, St. John Neumann, Blessed Francis Xavier Silas, even as we give thanks for Mother Mary Lang, whose cause is underway. And even as we remember with joy the visits of Blessed Mother Teresa. Today we should pray to the Lord to strengthen our families, that he'll give us the grace to renew family life in this archdiocese and beyond. Too many discussions about contemporary lifestyles center only on adult feelings and overlook the needs of children and young people. Let us be a church that honors our elders, sustains those in the prime of life, but indeed a church that welcomes our young with enthusiasm and joy and partners with parents in the task of forming the next generation. I thank our parents and our educators who at considerable sacrifice sustain our excellent Catholic schools in a time of great challenge. I also want to thank those who lead and serve our religious education programs, our youth programs, adult faith formation, marriage enrichment, and so much more. All of this exists to sustain you in your beautiful but challenging vocation as married men and women, as fathers and mothers of families who are the bedrock of our society and the strength of our parishes. How earnestly we pray also for strong, active, faithful lay leadership throughout the Archdiocese. To those of you who in loving service generously place your talents at the service of the Church's mission, I thank you. I thank here also of the Order of the Holy Sepulchre, the Order of Malta, the Knights of St. Peter Claver, the Knights of St. John, and many other dedicated groups within the Church. Yet donning my cap as Supreme Chaplain, allow me to single out the Knights of Columbus. What a surprise. Thank you so much for your spirit of charity, unity, fraternity, and patriotism. Thank you for your strong presence in this state of Maryland, where Cardinal Gibbons ordained the visionary founder of the Knights of Columbus, the Venerable Father Michael J. McGivney. Let's pray also that we may prove ourselves worthy ecumenical and interfaith partners, both in our search for unity and truth and in our service to the common good. May we always prove ourselves worthy partners in serving the needs of all, together with government, the business sector, and community groups. Queridos hermanos que hablan español, su presencia es una gran bendición para la Archdiocese de Baltimore. Ustedes son una fuente de fortaleza y alegría para mí. El Señor nos invita a evangelizar y debemos empezar con el testimonio de nuestras propias vidas. Queridos jóvenes, Dios continúa llamando a algunos de ustedes al servirlo en el sacerdocio o la vida consagrada. Abran sus corazones a Cristo, respondan con prontitud. Les pido sus oraciones y apoyo ahora que empiezo esta nueva etapa como su pastor. Yo les ofrezco las mías y mi compromiso de servicio constante. Gracias. You know, in today's gospel, Jesus says to his followers, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. That pretty much sums it up. So I'll leave you with this. This installation takes place practically on the eve of the Ascension. Can't we almost hear the risen Lord telling us to gather with the Blessed Virgin Mary, to watch and wait and pray for the coming of the Spirit at Pentecost? For it was at the coming of the Spirit at Pentecost that the apostles really grasped the mystery of Christ and found the courage to proclaim the gospel to the ends of the earth. What better way for us to begin this new chapter in the life of the Premier See than to dedicate the days leading up to Pentecost to prayer. To prayer that the Holy Spirit might be poured forth upon us in ever greater measure. What better way to begin than by begging the Spirit to pour forth the love of God into our hearts, so that we may be formed in Christ, so as to proclaim Christ by living the truth in love and by embracing love in truth. Through the prayers of Mary, our Queen, may God bless us and may God always keep us in his love. Thank you very much. God bless you all. Aware of God's love and presence, aware of God's love and presence and providence, we lift our hearts and voices in prayer for our needs and the needs of all the world.
Oye nos, Señor, Señor exaltado. for the church, that she may bring to the world the light and the power of Christ. And for those who serve the church, especially our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, all bishops, priests, deacons, consecrated religious and lay leaders, that they may be strengthened for their service to God's people.
Sallu min agl abina al oskof al amba lori, rai rae al kanisa fi Baltimore, al rab yainahu wa yu'ati an yakun kahinan kawi fa al iman, wa rai hakim wa oskofon mukaddasan.
Maka edeka n'otu ndi otu Kristi niile ya na udo n'etiti umu Chineke niile ka ndi niile kwere na Chukwu na-aga n'iru n'okwukwe n'ijere ya ozi.
Por un aumento en las vocaciones al sacerdocio, a la vida consagrada y al diaconado, para que Dios abra los corazones, muy especialmente de los jóvenes, y escuchen y respondan a su llamado con valentía, con perseverancia y con el apoyo de los demás.
Sa mga pinuno ng pamahalaan at lahat ng may pananagutang mag-alaga ng kapakanan ng lahat, naway maitaguyod nila ang kapayapaan ng sandaigdigan at katarungan para sa lahat ng mamamayan. Manalangin tayo sa Panginoon.
Pour les pauvres, les sans-travail, les affamés, les sans-abri de l'archidiocèse de Baltimore, que par notre générosité de cœur et de service, nous trouvons moyen de leur donner ce dont ils ont besoin.
Thank you.
Merciful Father, hear the prayers of your church gathered here before you. Strengthen us in love that we might serve you in one another through Christ our Lord.
Nice to meet you. Who's this? Kevin. Nice to see you. Thank you. Hi. What's your name?
I'm Joe.
Hi, Joe. And who's this?
Wendy.
Wendy. Nice to see you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi. And who's this? Hi, Kristen. Nice to see you. And this is? Nice to see you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
corpus panem hominem, ex cornibus fiat panis vitae. Benedictus est Domine Deus universi, qui ad et relogit et cepimus vinum, quod tibi offerimus fructum vitis, corpus panem hominem, ex cornibus fiat potus spiritualis, in spiritu humilitatis animo, contrito suscipiam ante Domine sex sacrificium, spectro tuo hodie, et placia tibi, Domine Deus. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive our offerings, O Lord, and transform them into the mystery of salvation, so that by its power we may be set aflame with the charity of the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church, and with her may be united more closely to the work of redemption, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to proclaim your greatness with due praise as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary. Receiving your word in her immaculate heart, she was found worthy to conceive him in her virgin's womb, and giving birth to the Creator, she nurtured the beginnings of the church. Standing beside the cross, she received the testament of divine love and took to herself as sons and daughters all those who, by the death of Christ, are born to heavenly life. As the apostles awaited the Spirit you had promised, she joined her supplication to the prayers of the disciples, and so became the pattern of the church at prayer. Raised to the glory of heaven, she accompanies your pilgrim church with a mother's love, and watches in kindness over the church homeward, the church's homeward steps, until the Lord's day shall come in glorious splendor. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Benedict, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you.
For them, we offer you the sacrifice of praise,
or they offer it for themselves.
And all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary,
Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, Your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, as Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many
for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace.
Grant them, O Lord, we pray,
and all who sleep in Christ,
a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, those sinners,
hope in your abundant mercies.
Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs,
with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter,
Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints.
Admit us, we beseech you, into their company,
not weighing our merits,
but granting us your pardon
through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Precepta solitaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in caelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra,
sicut et nosti mitibus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione, sed libera nos a malo.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Bill, peace be with you, Bill. Thank you.
May the peace last forever.
Thank you so much.
Bill, peace be with you. It's so good to have you here.
Thank you. Lord's peace. Lord's peace. Thank you. Lord's peace.
Bill, thanks so much, Bill. Thank you.
Thank you. Ed, Lord's peace be with you.
Well done. Beautiful words.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Eminence, peace be with you, Eminence. Thank you so much.
Thank you for the nice job you did in the homily.
Thank you, Eminence. Thank you. Thank you so much. Lord's peace be with you.
Magnificent peace.
Thank you, Frank.
Peace.
And peace be with you. Thank you.
Peace. You've done good this time.
Thank you. Lord's peace be with you.
Wonderful job.
Thank
God
you.
Bless you. Thank you.
Congratulations. Well done.
Thanks, neighbor.
Way to go, Bill.
Oh, my former neighbor. Thank you. It's peace. Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Peace be with you. Lord's peace.
Lord's spirit.
Lord's peace. Thank you.
God's peace,
Archbishop. Thank you so much, Rex. Lord's peace. Thank you. Lord's peace. Don, peace be with you. Thank you. Peace. Thank you. Peace. Thank you, Jim.
Say, reign, reign, all be peace, our Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Cardinal O'Brien. Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, Aunt Rose. Body of Christ. And free the body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, sweet. Thank you. Body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Uncle Body of Christ. 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 Amen. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Amen.
body of Christ, please. Body of Christ, sister. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Now, Bobby, body of Christ. Body of Christ, God. Bob, body of Christ. Body of Christ, Pam. Amen. Body of Christ. Baby, it's body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, Father. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, God. Body of Christ.
Amen.
All body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ.
Amen.
Sister, body of Christ.
Thank you.
Sister, body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Let us pray. Having received the pledge of redemption and of life, we humbly pray, O Lord, that with the Blessed Virgin Mother's help, your church may teach all nations by proclaiming the gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit, fill the whole earth through Christ our Lord. Be seated only for a minute. I won't be long. If we go much longer, this will count for Sunday. Again, Archbishop Vigano, thank you so much for representing our Holy Father today. Thank you, the cardinals who are with us, especially Cardinal Keeler and Cardinal O'Brien, archbishops, bishops, priests, deacons, religious, Knights of Columbus, seminarians. Thank you all so much. And for our wonderful laity from far and near. It's truly a celebration of our church. My thanks to our auxiliary bishops in a special way. My thanks to the Installation Planning Committee under the leadership of Monsignor Rick Boy. Rick, we thank you so much. There you are. Thank you so very much. Thank you. And my goodness, our deep gratitude to our musicians. Not only did we pray twice, I think we prayed three times. Thanks to you. Thanks, everybody. Thank you. Gratitude as well to Monsignor Rick Hilgarten, the Masters of Ceremonies, the servers, the office staff from the Catholic Center who provided an enormous amount of logistical support, Monsignor Jarbo and the staff here at the cathedral, also Monsignor Valenzano and the staff at the Basilica for last night's ceremony. My thanks as well to Father Tom Hurst and the staff of St. Mary's Seminary, our Knights of Columbus, and all those who have come from near and far, most especially my mom and dad, without whom none of us would be here today. Thank you so much. It's a joy and a grace, and dear friends, in the joy of this moment, let's stand now and let's really ask the Lord to bless us. Dominus vobiscum, sit nomen Domine benedictum, adjutorium nostrum in nomine Domini, et benedicat vos omnipotens Deus Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thank you. divine has led us in the past, in this free land, by who our lot is cast, be our strong ruler, guardian, guide, and stay. Refresh your peace.